tell me why it is that it takes two people to keep a stationary building under surveillance?
We're watching for Jack Golding.
Why two of us?
If only one person was here, and two people came out and went in two different directions, one of us couldn't do a fully professional job. See, we have to be prepared for every eventuality.
What if three people came out of there and went in three different directions?
Don't be ridiculous.
It's an eventuality I think we should prepare for.
We drink Pat.
What if eight people came out of there?
There aren't eight people in there.
They could have brought some in overnight.
Have you cancelled this thing of yours this afternoon?
No, I promised my uncle I'd go. Can we have the radio on?
You'll have to cancel your uncle, Kent. We have a meeting with a client.
You go. You can do it. Turn the radio on.
You're an albatross, Kent. You want to take a good, solid look at your priorities, son.
What the hell is she doing?
G'day, boy.
Get in the car, Pat.
What for?
Get in the car and do as you're told. Just what the hell do you think you're doing, strolling up here in broad daylight? I have to completely rethink the whole exercise. You've just blown our cover, Pat. You have just blown the only advantage we had.
You're an albatross, Pat.
How are you, Ken?
Haven't had so much fun since I took my auntie to the pictures.
Jack Golding's been arrested.
Don't be silly, Pat. We're watching his house now.
He was arrested in Brisbane. He's been on the radio all morning. I was wondering why he hadn't come back.
He's not a homing albatross, Pat. He's just a very ordinary, dopey albatross.
Personal assistant.
Great.
Hi.
Great. Thank you. Priorities.
Coffee?
Yes, one more. Thank you. Stella, could you squeeze the juice from some coffee beans for us?
Will do.
You people are from...
Excelsior Research Foundation.
Right. Sorry. Yes, I offered you coffee, didn't I?
Yes,
yes you did.
Yes.
Felicity. No, sorry, I was wondering whether I should call the lovely Felicity in on this one. She runs creative. I will, I think. We're bound to cross over at some point, is it, Lodi May? Stella, would you ask Felicity if she could spare me 10?
Sure.
Comfortable?
Great, thanks.
Sewerage.
Adrian, Felice, is it urgent?
Not urgent, no, but if you could spare us a few minutes, I'll make sure you get a mention in the New Year's Honours list.
Sadly.
Stella, would you get me Bruce Messer in the office? Bruce with the handlebars, right, the meaty chunks, jingle.
All right. You wanted me?
Until the 12th of November. Bryce, Pat.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Do you want to see your coffee?
Any herbal?
Chamomile?
Yes, please, why the tea?
I've got Bruce on the line.
Tell him I'm out, love.
No, I thought I called for Bertie, Stella.
You called him?
Oh, damn, so I did. Oh, I'd better take it. Sorry, folks, it's a madhouse here today.
Don't worry, it's the same at our place.
Busy?
Oh, never stop.
Now, it is a particular pleasure for me to present our most accomplished tradesman award for this year to a young man who has elected not to take the easy options, but rather with hard work and determination to fashion a career in our expanding metal industry. To receive your award, would you please step forward, Darren Ablett.
Good beauty, Baba. Woo!
If you seek our monument, look about you. A lot of image, a bit of product. I think we occupy the high ground. Our stuff is valid. We hire the very best people, and we have more fun than a blonde woman. We do natural fruit products, zippy pet food, the Labour Party here that lives in two other states, Henderson's biscuits,
Uncle T's cracker, that stuff.
Care for the oldies, leave those drugs alone, don't bash a baby. Oh, we're pitching for the Spazos this year, too. We do the Parker van, four-wheel drive ramper camper, the one with the 47 safety features.
They're bloody fantastic, those things.
Absolute death trap, never get in one. They're made of cardboard and the brakes are a real problem. Still, they sell. What can you do? It's a democracy.
Now the boys look good together. They always wear the smart ones, those two.
Hey, I am.
You always wear different you two, even when you were little.
All the others are girls, though. It'd be funny, surprising if you couldn't tell the difference.
Oh, come on, you know what I mean.
Collingwood lost him out of that.
Let's go for a walk, Kim. I think Dad's going to make a little speech about Darren.
Well, hang on. I'll come too.
Darren, come here, you little bugger. You listen to your father. But he's gone to a lot of trouble for all this.
Listen a bit of us. Listen a bit of us. Come on, belt up over there.
What exactly is it that you would like us to do?
Let me answer that in two parts, honey.
Get this down, Pat.
This is a crazy business.
Crazy.
A little idea, fresh approach, better defined market profile can mean the difference between a product struggling and a sliced bread type scenario. Now, the key ingredient is often small, often simple. Question of a new direction, new philosophy, upping the integrity. Putting a yes where there used to be a no. Michael Jackson.
It's ephemeral.
Well, it's a complete ephemeral, bro. Biggest danger in the creative arts. Best. Case in point, reason for discussion. Sweeto.
The mint.
The round mint. Adrian and I are developing new campaigns at night. Takes us 6 months. No sleep, never home. We come up with a completely new approach. Probably increase their gross sales by 8%.
Oh, 12%.
Tons of research, new jingle, big man presenter, rhythm, colour. Oh, we're going to kill them. Basic new campaign. Sweeto. The mint. Chew, chew, and chew.
And chew. So, what happened? We have a media schedule like a blanket bombing raid. We have a happy client. We're all ready to go. Stop! Whoops. Agency down the road here hits television and print the day before we open with a new chewing gum campaign for long last. The gum you can chew and chew and chew and chew and chew.
I don't believe it.
It's absolutely true, I swear.
What do you think, Ken?
I don't think I'm suited, Elf. I'm a bit young for a modelling course.
Oh, he's in Melbourne. He's just going to job at the bank to do the course.
A bit risky, isn't it?
Crazy. Sid's going to kick her out. She was out of work for 18 months before she got the bank job. And now she's chucked it in and spending the money on this.
Who's running it?
Futures modelling. That's as much as I know about it.
Tell you what. Do you want me to look into it for you in the quiet? Just find out who's running the thing, right?
Would you?
No trouble.
I won't want you to give up your other work. But I am rather worried. I'll pay you.
Yes, well, of course you would. You have to. It's a business arrangement. I'd want a banana cake just like the one over there I just ate.
You're a good boy, Ken.
A bloke in our creative division, Brendan Mark. He's the only one who could have known about the full sweetheart. Back on the end there. Sit on
it. You are not seriously going to invade Brendan Marr's private life, are you? It's against the law.
The man is a criminal, Pat. He is beyond the law.
We don't know that.
Look, you've been with us for 6 months now, Pat. Surely you can read the signs better than that. Miles is an industrial spy. Face facts.
It's not a fact, Bryce. It's a guess.
Look, I don't have time to defend criminals, Pat. If Adrian and Felicity believe the man is bent, then I must trust their judgment. I mean, you don't get the top of the advertising world by being a complete moron.
wind that up, please, Ken. We're leaving.
Who are you talking to?
I don't know, but it isn't company business.
That'd be right. Just talk among yourselves, will you? Yeah, look, can you get in to ring me back? Yep, 998254. Ken. Charm school finished early today, did it?
For the life of me, I don't see why I have a partner. I run this company single-handedly as it is.
You're a great man, Bryce. Probably the greatest man in the history of the world in some respects.
Who were you ringing?
Consumer protection.
It's all just a big joke to you, isn't it? Now, I put myself on the line. I do a huge sales pitch to Integrity Advertising. I win them over. I take this company into the big league, and it's all just a big joke to you, isn't it?
Don't know about big.
Why were you ringing Consumer Protection?
My auntie's a bit worried. There's my cousin chapped a job in to do a modelling course.
Family business.
Which course?
You're sabotaging this entire operation because of family. I thought we discussed that.
A place called the Futures Modelling School.
Are they any good?
I don't know yet. That's why I'm ringing up.
I'll never pay. We won't see a cent for any of this. They're leeches, those people. Take, take, take. Well, you're not doing it in company time. I'll tell you that right now.
I'll give them a ring if you like, Ken.
You will not.
You've been to the toilet today, Bryce?
Stealth. That's the key element in the business of unlawful entry into a building. Stealth and possibly closing a window.
What a great plan. What are you going to do?
I'm going to bump the place.
Yeah, well, you better be quick. You'll be home in about 5 hours.
Research by independent experts has shown that there's nothing that brings a marriage together more than an obvious catastrophe next door.
You realise you've completely destroyed that thing?
You fix that with a few bits of glass and some putty?
That is a restoration commode stand. That's handmade glass, you idiot.
Yeah, why'd you put the cord or I'd trip over it?
What was that?
A sort of loud banging noise.
Is that little light on? What was that? Why is there no power?
You blame the fuses.
Yeah, well, why is this thing working?
Probably on auxiliary power. Don't touch it.
What is it?
Don't touch it.
Hello there.
Ooh.
Lovely day for it.
Oh, nobody knows anything about the future modelling.
You didn't find time to do a spot of real work by any chance, did you?
Yes. The possibly quite innocent Brendan Miles was due to leave Integrity Advertising for lunch today at 12:30 p.m.
It's 12:15 now.
Well, that's impossible. We'd never get there in time.
Who dares wins, Ken? There are those who take risks. And those who don't. You're looking at a risk taker. Cover for me.
That's real, Seeger. Do you want the car keys? I'll throw them to you. It's a bit of a risk, but that's the sort of guy I am.
Brendan Miles.
Well, do you know anything about a break-in in Hawthorne this morning?
No.
A car very much like yours was seen being used by the bandits to get away.
Bandits?
Stay perfectly calm, Pat. Like just relax. Leave it with Ken. He knows what he's doing. He's a complete professional.
Went a bit of a knees up last night. When I woke up this morning, it was this afternoon.
Well, what about the Scarlet Pimpernel? Thanks. Where's he been?
Don't know. Won't tell us. He phoned in a while ago to ask what day it is. The sun coming up, so security risk, right? He's trained himself to operate in a complete information vacuum.
Do you know anything about the Futures Modelling Agency?
No, who are they?
Pat, don't be boring.
Would you like Bryce to phone you when he gets in?
You might tell him that he could come and pick his jacket up. Whoever did this break-in must have stolen his jacket and inadvertently left it at the scene of the crime.
Do something. She starts bad. Oh, she's such a fool.
Mm. Why don't I enrol?
No, you can't do that, Pat.
No, dear, it's all right. You stay out of it. Ken will think of something.
Well, Ken can't go down there any more than you can, and he can't enrol. Well, I don't see anything wrong with it. I enrol, I go to a couple of classes, and I see what they're like.
Might work.
Well, it'd probably only be for a day or two.
I don't know. It's very kind of you, but really, I can't let you just drop everything.
Ken, I delegate you to look after the office while I'm away. And light advice about where I am.
It's risky, Pat.
Ken, you're looking at an ex commander here.
Okay, that'll be $70, mate.
Fine. Just send the bill to the Excelsior.
Cash.
That's absurd. I'm the managing director of the Excelsior Research Foundation.
Well done. Me, that's all right. $70, cash.
What the hell did I do with my jacket?
Somebody else with a very similar name who stole your comb and your wallet and a couple of letters from your mother.
Jack, could you squeeze the juice out of some coffee beans?
We ought to put the shutters up here, close the whole operation down and go into advertising. There is so much money in advertising, you wouldn't believe it. And it's an ideas medium.
I just heard an ad on the radio for a woman's deodorant spray.
Some of those are very clever.
Squirt your way to personal confidence with Freshine. They've got the biggest personal freshness showroom in the Southern Hemisphere, apparently.
That's tasteless.
Mm, it's completely tasteless, apparently.
Now, I've dropped down a few ideas through the storyboard stage. Now, we start off with small accounts and clothing stores, bulk electrical outlets, then head straight for fast food and Japanese cars once we've picked a few goals.
I gather from all this that this bloke you were following...
Yeah, Brendan Miles.
Mm. I gather from all this you must have lost him about 15 or 20 minutes after you found him.
Television ads, now that's where the real money is.
We could run a national campaign asking him to phone you.
I tell you what, Pat. Give us the 400 now. Don't tell a soul. And Lorray and I will slip you into the one-year course.
A year?
It takes time to train a truly top-class model.
The advancement said $80.
Yeah, well, the advertising agency screwed that up, actually. That's just the introductory course, the important class.
Besides, it's booked out for 5 years in advance.
Put your moniker there, Pat.
I'm not really interested in signing up for the whole year.
I have just given you the opportunity of a lifetime. Something that any other girl in this country would sell their mother for, and you're turning your back on it?
Yeah, sorry.
Besides, we don't offer this to just anyone. A 12-month course with a promise of work at the end?
I'm sorry, I'm just not interested in signing up for the whole year.
Now, hang on, Pat. Let's just think about this.
Thanks.
You arrested?
I can't find her.
Did you see Pat?
She's not there.
I'll find out anything about futures modelling.
No.
You had a great day, aren't you? So hard for you to catch lotto tickets.
Some men observe the world as it is and ask why. Some dream of what might be and ask why not. Some men sit in the car and try to figure out what's going on.
I can't even hear what they're talking about with these things on. You're never going to be able to record it on that.
Look, mate, this thing is ultra sensitive and pick up the sound of a mouse breathing from 30 feet away.
I've heard car horns with more fidelity than that. Ping them up and ask him to yodel. I'm going.
But on a case, Ken. We're also getting to be a fairly major feature in the day-to-day life of this street.
Yes, well, we've probably got enough on tape to put miles away for a very long time indeed. Let's go.
But nobody knows we're here. That's the whole point of the exercise.
Christ, what was that?
Let's go, Kent.
Oh! Don't worry about it, girl. It happens all the time.
Sometimes I wonder why I get myself into these things. I don't know why I ever suggest anything. On the other hand, I suppose it's better than just sitting around doing nothing. That's probably why the other girls are here, too.
Terrific. That's just what we wanted. Right, now, here's me.
Eileen.
Eileen, right. Let's get up there, Eileen. Come on. Quickly. Lots of photos to get to today. Just up here. Sit yourself down. Anywhere you like. I'll get back to you and just sit. Oh, what I see is beautiful. Oh, lovely big smile. That's a girl. Indian beetling and... Up with the music. Just a little bit up, bit more, bit up. Oh, you're going to love this, Eileen.
The sound won't be perfect.
Won't be anything.
Whatever you've got will help us form an overview.
Exactly. Just another part of the jigsaw. Background. An initial step.
Right.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, roll everything. What sort of equipment did you use? Was it the 361, was it?
No, it was designed to our own specifications.
Right. What were they?
$50. To hell with the expense. You want professional sound, you've got to pay for it. We're not happy with the placement of the device. We're going to ship it. I will try and get more of Miles' voice next time.
No, it gives us the context. That's Miles' voice.
This is probably the most embarrassed I've ever been. I can't remember being more embarrassed than this. I doubt that it's actually possible to be more embarrassed than this.
Very interesting. You are what we call a natural turner, Pat. Very good.
Okay, girls, your folios. Your folio isn't included in your tuition fee, as I'm sure most of you realise. And the cost will be $150. Now, I know it might sound a lot, but if you went to a photographic studio, it would cost you $450 minimum. And it'll last you a lifetime. But if you haven't got the 150, just go ahead with your folio and you can fix it.
I wouldn't worry too much about the 150, Ireland. If you've got any special cases, it takes some more artistic shots.
Did you get about three altogether?
That's a relief.
All the top-class agencies are doing it all the time. A chance for you to find a more natural way of expressing yourself.
You were. Very tasty. Tons of decorum.
Like Playboy.
Yes, exactly.
Well, first up, you've got a pitch, right?
Right.
Like, if I want your business, I've got a pitch for it, right?
Right.
Plenty of gloss and crap, bold bitches, pointing out what a genius you are, and how if you only had a lot of expensive commercials made for you by us, you'd make so much money you'd pee your pants, right?
Right. Who pays for all this? Well, you bill a client.
Yes, you bill a client.
What if you don't get the contract? Bliss?
Then you bill another client. Anyway, after that, we start to develop a campaign. We have dialogue with your people. We crunch the numbers, and then we spit out a bit of advanced work. Right?
Right.
Right. We start to focus. We get into profiles and demographics. We might talk targets with you. We might chew on some projections. Then we hit you with a storyboard and invite your silly marketing people to a gala preview. Simple as that.
And then you close the deal.
Right.
Really, it's very interesting, all this.
Sure.
Sure.
See you tomorrow. You serious about this course?
Yes.
But you don't seem to have a very positive attitude. You're doing all right, and you're a reasonable-looking sort. But you've rejected the idea of saving your folio costs and branching out into more artistic areas. Now, got a decent enough body, I can't think what's the matter. Of course, if you've got a problem, family problem, boyfriend problem, even a small sexual problem has always come to us. My door is always open. That's what I'm here for.
Yes, I realize that.
Truly, it would be a pity to be left behind. Come on, Pat. Loosen up, relax, enjoy yourself. And if you want anything, just whistle. You know how to whistle, don't you?
What is it? Photograph. Who took it? Miles took it outside his place last night.
Oh, my giddy aunt. Bring them in.
Any idea where to start looking?
Try Miles' place. Bryce has probably gone back to get his trousers.
I'm merely stating facts. The bugging device has to be repositioned and you have to do it.
I'm not going back there. We've been to the guy's place more often than he has.
Well, I can't go back. I've been recognised. I've had my photo taken.
Yes, so have I.
Yes, but it was mainly of me. You had your hands over your eyes. I was sitting there, staring straight up at the camera.
Yeah, why?
I was trying to work out what was happening. So far, I've had an electric shock. I've had an Etruscan hat stand collapse on my leg. I've been described with some accuracy by the neighbours, and I've had my photo taken. But I left my jacket there. They know who I am.
They haven't the foggiest idea I'm the poor bloody idiot that works with you.
Look, Pat's not doing anything. She can go.
Ah, she is. Where do you want the thing put?
What you doing?
Where do you want it put?
It's going to go pretty well.
Hi. I'm Pat.
Hi, Lily. Hi. How are you enjoying the course?
Fantastic, isn't it? Not all glamour, though.
No, not all of it.
It's really hard. Holding the post up.
Yeah. Listen, has Mr. Price said anything to you about posing nude for your follower?
Yeah. Has he asked you too? All the other girls have got to pay $150.
So you're going to do it?
Oh, yes. Hey, it's no big deal. Mr. Price is a real professional.
Okay, let's talk 60 then.
60,000 plus X plus Y plus Z.
More than money, Damien.
I'm sensitive today. Look, the fact is, Henley Dermack Henley has a position. You are that position.
I must have total creative freedom.
Well, naturally. We don't pay people 60 grand and expect them to sell coffee there. We're a team at HDH. We're a team of individuals.
Listen, can you give me a couple of weeks?
Sure.
We've got a crisis at home, President. We've been vandalized twice already.
Good afternoon, sir.
Mission accomplished. It was a complete success.
In what sense? I can't hear a thing. Where exactly did you place it?
Under the table, which was made of oak, so the magnet wouldn't work. So I improvised. I used chewing gum.
That's a class act, isn't it? I still can't hear anything.
Yes, well, you've probably got on the wrong frequency.
It's only got an on and an off switch. That's probably the wrong end.
Credit me with some intelligence.
This is fantastic. There was about a dozen of us from creatives and about another half dozen ADs. And we just pulled Range Rovers and headed bush. It is so important just to get away from all the bullshit and really clear your head. I'm hearing voices.
There you go.
We went to this beautiful spot.
I'm afraid I can't.
There is a whole class full of kids down there who think they're learning how to detect mice.
I can't just go about arresting people for taking nude photographs of young women. They've probably all signed some form consenting to it all.
These are false pretenses or something? Doesn't the Trade Practices Act deal with the sleazy mongrel section of the business community?
Not specifically, no.
What can I do?
Nothing without watertight evidence. It happens to us all the time. I'll give you an example. You know this house in Hawthorne that was broken into the other day?
I heard about it, yes.
Now, I knew who did that, but I didn't have enough evidence.
All I had was the number of their car, a whole lot of fingerprints, a jacket, a wallet, four or five eyewitnesses and a couple of photographs. This wouldn't have stood up. And now, yesterday, the same house was broken into again, more damage. And this time, the owner injured as well. Now, I know who did it, and I'm very angry about it.
What are you going to do?
I think we should do something together. You make sure Torval and Dean come and see me now, if not sooner, and I'll do what I can about this modelling school of yours.
Well, you're the secretary, Pat. Make an appointment.
I think you'd rather make an arrest than an appointment. For God's sake, I'm trying to help you. The least you can do is to keep Blair off my back.
Yeah, all right. Look, I'll be happy to see Blair. Tomorrow.
Right. Integrity. Felicity. Adrian. 2:30. We're taking you in.
Ken, are you with me? Dialogue at 2:30. Frank exchange of views. Hold the strategy up the light. See how we're doing. Possibly over Perno. Ken?
Why do I bother?
Can I ask you something?
Can we make this later, Pat?
Pat.
Can we make it later, Pat? I'm very busy right now.
These jobs that are guaranteed at the end of the course, what exactly are they?
What are they? What they are is top-flight modelling assignments.
With who?
With very exclusive international agencies.
Like who?
Artiste del Supreme.
Artiste del Supreme.
Look, what is the problem here? Artiste del Supreme are a bloody marvellous company. Multi-respected. They're highly regarded the world over. Rock solid, offices and so on. It is the opportunity of a bloody lifetime.
Frankly, I'm not so worried about the Sweden campaign. That small fry, a couple of hundred grand. But we're working on other things.
Bigger things.
Healer's toothpaste.
Adrian.
It's okay, I trust these guys. They're professionals. They ring all the right emotional bells. Quillies came to us with a concept. We liked it. It was strong. A new toothpaste that completely fixes cavities.
That's incredible.
Oh, yeah. Brilliant. Simple premise. Huge campaign. It'll sell millions. And we're in on the ground floor. Equity in the venture.
So when is it being released?
Sure.
Well, when it's invented.
Sure.
Cooley's still testing it, aren't they?
No, Quillies is a graphics company. Quillies Graphics.
You've developed a campaign for a product that doesn't exist
yet.
Sure.
That's right.
We're dabbling in futures here. We're a lead industry. We plan ahead. Concept extrapolation. And when the product is invented, we're ready to go.
But you can see why I'm so paranoid about keeping the whole thing quiet.
Yeah, you wouldn't want too many people finding out.
Oh, my point exactly. We think with one mind here. White man and Indian are brothers. So tell me, boys, what are you going to do about the spy?
Well, the campaign's about to enter a new phase. I think we've explored the old one fully now.
Agreed.
I think it's time for a new direction.
I like it.
We're going in to Henley Dermack.
Great.
Great.
An SAS type raid.
I love it. It'll be lots of fun. Oh, it's a very great concept, Ken.
It's an excellent concept.
Right, now let's see. That's it. That's the one that's perfect. Right, girl. Now, to be perfectly honest, most of your exotic international fashion threads are shot locally. You see, the light's much better in Australia. More ambience. More heaps of ambience. You know the telly ad for Bali perfume? Shot right here.
How did they do the water? That's my favourite ad.
Yeah. How did your photo session go the other day?
Oh, nice. It was very tasteful. Mrs. O'Rourke was there. It was very special, wasn't it?
Yes, no big deal. Were you there too?
Quite a few of us.
Eileen and I are doing another session tomorrow.
Yeah, it was great.
You're kidding.
It's okay. They're models too. Very artistic. Nothing dirty. Mr. Pye says he'll be trying for a European look.
I'm not surprised.
Look, it's better than being on the doll.
Hello there. We're the men to repair the pipes in the rooms of the council, Captain.
We're here to fix the pipes in the room of that busy account.
Oh,
that way.
Thanks.
Thanks, little darling. Come to the morning to you. Just shut up. Abdul.
Not for a bit, no.
Ah, what a marvellous day.
Delvin, phone's ringing. You guys creative?
Well, we like to think so, yeah.
No, we're not. We're from maintenance.
Right. Come with me. I've got a concept I'd like to throw at you.
You're happy to sit back and watch while these girls get dragged into the vice bracket, are you?
It's their choice. I'm not happy, no, but there's not much I can do about it.
They haven't got a clue of what they're doing. Most of them are unemployed. They're uneducated and they don't have any experience of anything.
Sounds like your boat.
They're being preyed upon.
Have you met a girl called Pauline Greaves doing the course?
No.
Short blonde woman. Started a few days ago. Constable Pauline Greaves.
Oh, thanks for telling me.
Vice boy's going to raise it.
Will they be arresting the girls?
They may not even arrest Price and O'Rourke. Petty stuff, that. A couple of small crims and some silly girls. I'm doing you a favour.
Well, thank you.
And I want one in return. Look, I don't want to arrest Laurel and Hardy, but if they don't...
They come to see you yet. Ken said they would.
Oh, they've seen me a couple of times. They've bolted.
Oh, they're idiots.
Yes, we know that. That fact is on file. Now, why did they break into Miles's house and hit him with a chair?
They hit him with a chair?
Well, in their defence, it might be said that whoever clobbered him apologised while they were doing it.
Ken, look, I'll make sure they come and see you by Friday, all right?
Tomorrow will do. Any later and I'm arresting them.
OK, we all agree?
Sure.
Yeah. Does anybody know?
Well, one of us.
OK, some of us are more unanimous than others. OK. Right. Onions. The campaign for the Onion Marketing Authority. Go with an onion.
Mm.
Love,
good.
Love it. Fabulous.
Good.
Strong. Good.
You're right there, boys.
Yeah, we're
okay,
fine.
Great, thanks. Just think thermostat. Yeah, background. Integrity came up with a campaign for the Federated Apricot Growers. Go with an apricot. And we like that. We think it talks people's language. We think it targets effectively. And we're happy to go with that on a go with an onion basis.
Yes,
yeah, but
Why are we always stealing ideas from integrity?
Two reasons. One, facts of life. Big agencies steal from overseas countries. Small agencies steal from big agencies. And two, the maintenance guys at Integrity have been dealing us their work for the past 8.5 years, and they've never been wrong yet. Frankly, the quality is too good to ignore. And despite what people say about advertising, quality is important. Turn it on now?
You better give it a couple of minutes to cool down, I think.
About 20 minutes.
Right. Try it tomorrow.
Maintenance men, would you believe it? Frankly, this is some of the best work we've ever done. Now, we worked as a team on this one. That was the key.
Blair would like to see you both first thing tomorrow morning.
Has he been here again?
No, I was seeing him. Oh, by the way, the rating suits his modelling. Places as quickly as they come. Eileen will be okay.
Oh, thanks, Pat. Thanks a lot.
You haven't been working for Ken's relatives again, have you? Now, I thought I was absolutely clear on this one, that under no circumstances was this company's resources to be used for unpaid work. Now you've chosen to drag the police into the affair, you've probably jeopardised our entire security web.
What did your security web do to Brendan Miles' place? You practically have to rebuild it.
That wasn't it.
Oh, good grief.
Miles? Who's this Miles? I don't think one called Miles.
Why don't you tell Blair that?
Who's he, Pat?
Simply not true.
It's grossly unfair.
Look, you have our word. At no stage during the past week or at any other time has Ken or I broken into the home of a man called Miles or any other house.
What's that?
A bugging device. Although why you left it in Miles' fish tank, I'll let you know.
Simply not true.
It was bought from a shop up here with Bryce's bank card.
You're on very shaky ground, you know. Didn't Pat report the loss of my bank card?
Liar. I have spoken to Miles, explained that you did it. Told him that you are possibly two of the stupidest men in Melbourne and that you probably didn't have a clue what you were doing. I told him you might even have had the wrong house. He took it very well. He's not a bad bloke.
Not true.
Quite true, I can assure you.
Can we see your superior?
No. Anyway, Miles, after a great deal of persuasion on my part, has agreed to drop all charges, provided you recompense him for the following. Two windows, one stained glass, a settee, that must have taken some effort, a wall clock, a plate glass coffee table, miscellaneous children's toys, one very substantial oriental figurine and one Scandinavian occasional chair, plus associated medical and personal suffering expenses.
How much?
$6,000.
When did he want it?
We won't pay.
When would he want it if he did pay?
We straight away. Not on. Where are we going to get $6,000 from?
Bank card?
There we go, folks. Burning oil well capped as per instruction. Guilty party identified as one Gustav Bovary, maintenance man of this parish.
Gustav? Well, pick on my knob.
Oh, it wasn't Brendan.
In no way, shape or form.
We were wrong.
Yes, well, you can't be right all the time, Adrian. It's only human to destroy the wrong house now and again.
I'm impressed. This is very good work. I like the way you've done it. It's good work.
She's not up and wrong, boy. You're very good indeed.
Well, I suppose you want to be paid. Yes, right. We thought pet food or tracksuit. But you decide. You can have it in convection heaters or pantyhose if you like.
Could we have it in a brown paper bag?
Is there any chance of cash?
Cash money? It's a bit hard in the short term, boy. And contra is the way to go, surely. A grocer tool of whippersnipper. Bulk apricots. Limitless apricots, any amount of them.
Actually, we were going to ask you to give us a bit of a hand, too.
Mm-hmm. We'll try.
We need $6,000.
Oh, well, we all need $6,000, boys.
There isn't a man alive who doesn't need $6,000.
Now, we need $6,000 in cash right now to pay restitution to Brendan Miles for damage we did to 99% of all household furniture.
$6,000?
Very tall, Vicky.
Well, we can't not pay it, or they'll take us to court and then they'll find out what we were really doing there.
Yes, I take your point. Now, what were you doing there?
We virtually sent them there.
Ah, yes. It all fled back to me now, yes. Bad PR, vibes not consistent with harmony in the workplace. $6,000. Mendoza account?
Can't. There's 11.5 grand worth of extensions to the beach house in there already.
Meteorite.
Car and 2 sets of seats.
Fine.
Leave those drugs alone.
School fees. You can't touch that. That's got socially redeeming features. Bear with me, boy.
Well, I can't see where we can get it from.
Sweeto.
Can't. The tickets are already booked. By the way, you've got to confirm Toronto, Bahrain. The booking's gone.
We need $6,000.
What do you need $6,000 for?
Because, Pat, paradoxical though it may seem, the White Tornado here and his mate in advertising are having a bit of trouble putting their hands on any actual cash money. Our entire payment for doing extensive renovations to much sought-after Hawthorne, 4 dozen sets of flannelette beanbag covers, a sharpener for a whippersnipper, and an industrial grinder that bolts into the wall.
Look, there's no point in throwing mud. This is a group problem. We have to find $6,000 in a hurry.
Hello, Henley Dermack Henley. Yes, I was wondering if I could have a word with Mr. Spears. Tell him it's about a new brand of toothpaste that cures cavities.
Good idea.
Just tell him Ken. From maintenance.
Slice of ham, anybody?
Yes, don't mind if I do.
Hope it kills him.
It's not all glamour in the research business. In fact, it's not all research in the research business. There's a fair bit of plain and simple everyday work delivering consignments for industry. It's elementary, but it's just as well to have top-notch professionals doing it, just in case something goes very slightly wrong.
And I know you want. The simple mistake happens all the time. Hey, Spain. Come on, you idiot. You got a car?
Yes.
Get into it and get out of here. Go down there 50 yards and put the package in the back of a white Valiant. And don't come here again or I'll kill you. Don't ever let me see you again. I'll kill you.
Well, that seemed to go pretty well.
No, I've got to go.
37 yes. Years old, long-winded, pompous. He was born with executive strength.
Thank you very much, yes.